ValiRx has announced today they've strengthened their worldwide patent protection for lead drug Val-201, having been granted a patent by the European office. For more, I'm joined on the line now by Chief Operating Officer Dr. George Morris. George, good to speak to you once again.
Good to speak to you as well.
George, run us through, first of all, the significance of what this means.
Well, it's always gratifying to have granted patent rather than just pending patent. But on this occasion, I think it's particularly important in that all the key markets in which we are currently doing work and are likely to be doing work are now protected and covered for the use and the cancer therapy applications of Val-201. We have had, obviously, cover on the manufacture of the compound and various others in the past, but now we have a seriously complete set of intellectual property rights covering its use in cancer and various other related conditions.
So where does this cover currently? Is it Japan, Australia, and Europe, is it?
We now have full cover in Australia, Japan, and in the relevant European Union and wider European Patent Agency territories, and we have a use patent pending in the US, in fact a couple of them pending in the US, of which we are hearing good things and have had little particular interaction in a negative way with the authorities.
So when do you might hear more on how those pending patents are coming along?
That is in the lap of whichever deity you believe in. It is a long process. It can be between 5 and 9 years in coming through. However, the priority date is what matters. Nobody is going to interfere with a product that has been patent protected and granted and prior art dates given in Europe, Japan, Australia, and many other subsidiary territories.
Oh, very good. Well, bring us up to speed, if you would, on where the compound's at in terms of the study. Have you had any results yet?
We've had very good, in fact, complete safety and tolerability on the compound up to what we believe is a sensible therapeutic dose. And we have had no serious adverse events that have been reported that are connected with the drug. We are also beginning to show early indications at the therapeutically relevant amounts of drug of its efficacy in reducing the effects of prostate cancer, which is the first trial we have. That is now an expanding trial where we will increase the rate of dosing in the next few months, and we should be able to get some really good early day indications on how well it works and who it really works for. We're extremely encouraged by what we've seen, and it exceeds our expectations in many ways.
And in terms of discussions with potential partners, how are those coming along?
We are discussing with a variety of partners, or potential partners, I should say, from the big 10 or 12 through to the quite small and geographically located individuals. Our best discussions currently are with mid-sized companies and organizations, but obviously I can't go into any real detail on that. It would be inappropriate to do so.
Well, I wish you all the best, George. Thanks for giving us an update.
Thank you very much for giving me the chance.